What's up? Welcome to the stream. It's day 310, make a Songbringer. And I'm hoping that the internet works today. I got some different settings now. Hopefully the quality's a little bit better, but the bit rate's good enough there to survive today's stream. What's up, Boogie? But today I'll be working on the poison bomb and the fear bomb. There's gonna be some new mechanics going on with the fear bomb. What's up, Hardboil? How you guys doing? So, first of all, let's run the game. Oh, plug in my headphones. Make sure the sound's working. I hope the stream works today, you guys. What's up, pizza? How's the new game coming, pizza? Alright, so the sound's not working there for my headphones, but hopefully it was working for you guys. Yeah, stream's looking good today. Okay, good. You can almost make out the text right on. Just making sure the sound's working. Oh yeah, okay, sound's working. It looks like no drop frames just yet, and it should be streaming at a lower bit rate, but still medium quality, like 600 pixels tall instead of the usual. I'm usually streaming at 800 pixels tall before all this internet madness started happening. What's up, Sal Dongs? Oh, I did some crazy good work last night to the secrets. So the secrets can be booked. So if you blow up a secret, and you haven't visited it yet, so check us out. Stream's looking good? Awesome. Yeah, I had a good weekend. How about you? Did anybody watch the Super Bowl? So now, this is a bug that Boogie posted on the Trello. It's basically if you reveal a secret like this, and then you later go off the screen or you go to somewhere else. Like, let's say I didn't have any bombs right now and I couldn't reveal this. The game remembers the fact that there is a secret on that area. It's not going to actually show you where the crack is, but it will show you on the map. So if I look at my map now, you can see there's a little like colon or two dots right there on this screen. That's indicating that there's a secret on this area that has not been claimed yet or hasn't been visited yet. Of course you watched it, that's right. Who are you rooting for, by the way, pizza? So now that I know that there's a bomb there, I can remember to come back to this area and explore it more, use a cactus again if I need to if I don't remember where it was, and then place the bomb. So that's cool. And also, I've started the secrets on different types of areas. So let's go to a different secret area and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Broncos? Right on. I like the emo you just used. Yeah, so here's an area that's a bush secret. So eventually these bush secrets, I'm thinking, will be, you'll have to use your fire abilities to get inside them. But for now, I just made it so bombs can blow up bushes as well. So there's gonna be a lot of new types of secrets on the overworld. Oh, it allowed it, yeah. So there's a little hole in the ground that I blew up with a bomb. And the game's also good about remembering that too. So if I go off the screen, come back, I'll always have this blown up thing. What's up, Azimris? MC Finest? How you guys doing? So today's goal is to work on the poison bomb and the fear bomb. And the fear bomb is gonna have a new mechanic where it's gonna make enemies run away. So that'll be, you know, that'll add a little bit of... If you don't pick up the secret, does it show it on the map? Yes. Oh, no, it won't show it if you haven't picked up the secret inside there. So, right, if I have visited or blown up... Ah, that's a good point, Hardboiled. That would change everything. Well, I could do it. I could do it. Let me add this to the Trello. I see what you mean. If you have 255 diamonds already, you find a secret. It'd be nice if it marked it on the map showing that you have not, that it's still there, you know, like, oh, hey, by the way, remember this secret thing you didn't get? Make it so secrets don't secrets are still marked on the map if the item inside has not been obtained. I'm pretty sure I can do that with a fairly simple that should be pretty simple, hopefully. Since I've been working on that right now, I'm just gonna throw it on the top of my list. 64 cards left to go in the codes. Bugs, 26 more cards left in design. Does the hole show on the map? No, the hole does not show on the map if you've already been inside it. No pizza bomb? No, there's no pizza bomb. What's up, Arcane? Yeah, it happens too many times. That's important. I'm glad I got that marked on the to-do list now. Hey, what's up, Zynger? Okay, so poison bomb. Let's just work on the poison bomb right now. If I remember correctly, it should be applying its poison bomb-y effects already. It's just that it's not actually doing a separate animation for the poison bomb. So I think it's just it's visual stuff today. All right, this is a horrible area to test the bombs out. We need an area with lots of enemies, like a switch room. Let's go to level 2. This will do. Let's find the switch room. Oh, hey, it's right here. Wow. I must know this world already. Okay. You got an exam tomorrow? Yes, you can't fall asleep? Oh man, I didn't know you were going to school. What are you going to school for? Mighty Nest! Yay! I'm so glad you noticed that bug fix. Oh man, thanks for saying something. I'm so glad. Because whenever I'm fixing these bugs, man, there's so many bugs I fix, and I'm like, God, I hope the people like this. You know, so it's really, I'm glad you said that. I'm glad that worked, too. So the bug that got fixed there that Mighty Ness is talking about is when you would run and then get hit by an enemy, when you use the keyboard, it would make you stop and then you'd have to repress the key. But for some reason on gamepads, it didn't do that. So basically I fixed it so that if you're running and you hit an enemy, and you keep holding the button down, you'll start running again. So it's a lot smoother gameplay with the keyboard. Oh yes, good. Okay, so poison bombs are working. They just need an effect. So all those blobs just got poisoned. Let's poison some more. You'll see they turn green and they leave us a slime trail for a little while. Poison does a lot of small damage over time. Mechanical engineering, cool. The small pause, yeah, that small pause was already there. That's always been that way. So you like you get hit, you know, it takes a little second. Yeah, cool. So hopefully these poison bombs look even better once the visuals for them are done. So in first of all, when it does the When it does the poison effect, I think that's an AI system. When it explodes a bomb, yeah, we need to do the poison. Might as well hook all these up. All these new bombs. I think these are all implemented already. When I teleported back from Sombra, I was still wearing the t-shirt. Now you can't equip the nano sword? Are you sure you can't equip the sword? Did you try? Did you try everything? Did you try using other items and stuff? What's more important, the t-shirt or the sword? Oh. Well, let me show you how to fix it, Scottish Pizza. If it's totally not working, go to your save file. Go into your saves.txt. It's right inside your games directory. I know you've hacked this before, so you've probably been in here before. So just go to your saves.txt. Find your the zero, use the there's each one of your saves is a it starts with a number. So this is save number 0. So you probably want to go to your save number 0 and go to your A and make sure it says sword. That's really important. And then also you might if you also want to check if your items has the sword. So if you're in your item sword, if that's 0, then something really weird happened to your save file. But definitely set that to 3. Yeah. So make sure you have a sword and make sure that your button is equipped to the sword there. Yeah, that'll fix your save file. And I guess I'll have to look at. Can you give me any more information on that? On how that happened? Warping back from Songbringer and still had shirt on, which the shirt shouldn't have even been on, and couldn't use sword. Anyways, I'll take a look into trying to figure out why that might have happened or how in the world your sword would not even be able to be usable. So it looks like that did not compile correctly because what? Fear explosion, poison explosion, and lightning explosion have not been implemented. That's fine. Glad I already hooked these methods up to the header. Okay, so headers. What do we need headers for anyways? When's Jai coming out? Okay, so the last thing I was working on yesterday was ice explosion. Let's hook up lightning explosion. Actually, let's get the colors in here too. Fire colors, ice colors, well, lightning colors, poison colors, fear colors. Oops, ice, lightning. You just finished level 1, teleported to Songbringer, walked about, teleported back, and that happened. Okay. Me add a little comment. So you teleported back to Songbringer straight from level 1. What room were you in? Were you in the goal room where it has the teleport field? Or were you in. Were you back at the entrance of level 1, or were you back in the overworld? Just wants to party, totally.
Babe, I need the screwdriver and the hammer.
Okay. Oh.
There's a little orange thing just sitting right there.
No.
Sorry, everyone. It's right there.
It's not accessible.
Thank you. Sorry. Sorry, everyone.
So good. Yeah, okay, you're right at the goal. Boogie says Zeus forgives you. That's nice of you, Boogie. Lightning, poison, fear colors. Let's hook these colors up right now. While we're doing this, might as well, right? Do them all at once. She's cool. She's great. If you guys ever come to San Francisco and we meet up sometime, have a drink, I'm sure you get to meet Miss Wizard Foo. Soon to be Mrs. Wizard Foo someday. Once we get our act together, save up enough money to actually have a wedding. Weddings are expensive. Good lord. Okay, poison colors. These are easy. Here's one poison color. Oops. So we need poison, lightning. What's up, clock? You're young to drink, but you do it anyways? There's one poison. Totally, right? Sorceress Foo. Yeah. Let's do this green. And this darker green. All right, lightning. Lightning kind of has its, like, only one speed. I guess that's a tiny bit different. Let's hope that's a tiny bit different too. All right, we got lightning colors, poison colors, fear colors. This is mostly black, usually. You're so tempted to change the textures? Do it. That's what modding's for. Let's go with some of these deeper colors for fear for now. These are, I'm probably going to need to tweak, because when you're using dark colors and additive lighting and stuff, it just doesn't work. You can't even see it. Okay, there. Now we got these colors hooked up. There's lightning explosion, lightning colors. Where are they at? Here we go. Oh. Lightning colors. And the last one should be fear. Fear particles, fear explosion. Yeah, that's all you do. Sword next to A. Let me show you again. It's just sword. That's all you need. What's up, Teak? Strong attack? Yeah, no, it's definitely going to be in the game. It's just I'm so deep in bugs and stuff like that that I have not even been able to get to so many things. But yes, that's definitely going to be in the game. It's like a charged attack. Like you'll hold a button down, release it, and it'll do more damage, and you'll gain that ability in some like special dungeon. Right, pizza. So fear explosion. Fear explosions. Fear colors. That should be the basics to get it compiling with all these bombs having effects now. So next time you just gotta check out the fear explosion or the lightning explosion, the poison explosion, and the fear. What happened to poison explosion? I missed out on the. Here we go. Poison trail. Poison. Nice, it worked good. Awesome. Yep, that's how you can cheat too. But keep in mind that the cheating will only happen for now. While it's in the alpha and beta versions. Once the game is finally complete, there will be some kind of encryption in placed on these files. So you won't be able to edit your save game unless you're a super duper awesome hacker. All right, now we should have it compiling and all these methods are ready to go. Now we just gotta test out the poison bomb, test out the lightning bomb, test out the fear bomb, and then add the fear mechanic. I'm a party pooper. Well, how else are we gonna keep people from cheating on the leaderboards? Because eventually there's gonna be a leaderboard where it keeps people's scores. So if people can cheat, and they're just gonna be able to dominate the leaderboard really easily. I think we already discussed this in another stream. Basically, what'll happen is I'll add some kind of encryption and test the checksums. So basically, you'll still be able to cheat later on, but it won't add your score to the leaderboard if you've cheated. So best of both worlds. Oh, you're kidding? Oh, sorry, I take things too literally sometimes. All the time. I'm a programmer at heart, man. I take things too literally. Gotta lighten up. Right, you know what? This is looking okay. The poison effect is working. I guess. Oh, you know what? Let's use the poison has its own little blood white. That's it. Let's do blood white for its frame. So this will have a nicer look to it. Oh, Kappa. Even that, I don't even always notice the Kappa, so. You like the poison sound? Cool. Yeah, let's make sure those are working as well. Let's make sure it has a sizzle noise, like when it hits the ground. Sizzle noise when it hits anything, really. Like if I just set it off right here. Ah, they're so big. Yeah, I think this needs a sizzle, no matter if it hits the regular ground. Wait. Forget, this is sound key. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so sizzle, sizzle. And this should only be 0.25, maybe, plus DRAND F. A 1 times 0.25. You want to poison everything? Yeah, you can do it. You can cheat. Right now, you can cheat your way into having poison everything. The game won't actually allow you to craft more than one type because you can never acquire more than one element. So you can have either poison bombs, the poison hat, or the poison sword, but you can't have all three at this point. Those are too small. Oh, because it's a pretty small thing. So let's do 1.0 plus Another half, maybe. Points. Teak, you almost have enough points for to enter the raffle. At 1,000 points, you can win a Steam key. It's a 25% chance. And if you want, you can keep saving your points for more and more of a percentage chance. That was a little big. The 0.5 plus. Let's do 0.6 plus 0.4? You really like the fear twist? Awesome. Well, the whole game is based on fear and courage. Your life is courage, basically. Give super, super, super secret poison cubes, and I go poison everything. All right. You already own the game in beta? Good for you. Well, if you, you can always give away your key, or, like, you know, do something, sell your key, whatever. Alright, that's looking alright, except I would like, I think I want the colors to be a little, 2.75 there, 2.5 here, and the colors for poison to be a little more of the green. This brighter yellowy color is a little too bright. So that, we already used this color and that color, let's do that color as well. Sell them back to me. I meant the fear element. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, the fear element. That's what I was saying was that the whole game is kind of based around courage and fear. So I guess fear was kind of an inevitable element. But I see what you mean. It is kind of a unique element that there's not really any other games out there that use fear as an element of the game. But this world is meant to be like that. This world is meant to have courage is as your life force, and fear as the opposite of life force, sort of like damage, I guess. See, even that's a little bit too light in color. So let's go darker on all these colors. This one too, 4, 5, 8. Oh yeah, that was deeper. Yeah, let's put it there. Yep, beta's this month. Yeah, Jib can be poisoned. You can be poisoned. Yeah, it is acid. Sorry. It already is called acid. I keep calling it poison, but it's, check it out.
That one's called poison. But yeah, this is supposed to be called the acid bomb, the acid element, the acid top hat.
Let's fix the poison blink. There we go. Acid blink upgrade. Transform into acid. Yeah, so it should be called acid because yes, Jib can get hit by the acid. I keep calling it poison because the whole code is using the word poison. But yes, technically in the games, from a gamer's perspective, it'll be called acid. Yep. Sorry, I've been working on the max frame rate, but I haven't been able to figure out how to crack 60 frames a second on Cocos 2DX. Cocos 2DX has some hard limit that they set at 60. But you can right now you can go to your saves.txt and set it to 120 if you want, or 240 if you want, whatever. It might work.
It might work for you, but for some reason on my computers, it only allows 60. But maybe on Windows, it actually can go higher. I don't know. Try it. Okay, let's see if that poison color look better now. You need to make it 14 frames a second max. Yeah, Slain. I backed Slain way back when they had a Kickstarter. I can't wait for it to come out. Slain looks really awesome. They're still a little small, so lightning. No. Poison. Explosion. Now, these should be 1.0 plus a half. Can I find it with the metal detector? Oh, Azurus, I didn't even think about VSync. But that can be disabled. I don't think I added an option to the menu yet, but you can turn off your VSync. Oh yeah, it's already a default option. Yeah, so you can just turn on disable VSync. Turn that to 1 and it will disable your VSync, and then you maybe can go faster. What's up, Emma? Do bombs trigger other bombs? Like if I set off a bomb, does another one blow up? No, not yet. It doesn't do that. I'm not sure. What do you think? Should it? There's gonna be a mine. There's gonna be a mine item as well. That doesn't really have anything to do with triggering bombs though. See, now that's too big. Okay, at most, let's do 0.25 added. Oh, I was running at 60. Computer started getting hot. All right, that's let's see how that looks in this big room. Why does the Steam FPS counter not work with Songbringer? It does if you run it in windowed mode or something like that, or if you run it in full screen mode, I'm not sure. One of the two, it does work. Good. I like it. That's good enough. Let's call that one good and done. Poison bombs. Done. Brrr. Done. Also, it's running so much smoother now. How's it running smoother? All right. So let's hook all this up. Call it done. Poison bomb's done. Great. Okay, next one. Let's do lightning bomb. Lightning bombs are awesome because they shut off lightning everywhere. This one might need to do a little, actually make a little bit less awesome because it's so powerful. Done, next, yes. That's more than one thing done today. Because I'm working on the second thing already. So here's what happens with lightning. Let's see if we get hit with it. Yeah, you got hit with lightning. How about those particles? I don't know about these particles yet. Yeah, that does so much damage. Huh. It probably needs to do a little bit less damage, because compared to the other bombs, it's just so kick-ass. Can't connect connect to Steam to check the FPS camera if I remember it working. Oh yeah, see it works somehow. There's some mode. Can you kill bosses with it? Yeah, you can kill bosses. So how can I make this a little weaker? What's going on right now is the bomb itself does a lot of damage, and then the lightning also does a small amount of damage. I guess the actual bomb itself probably needs to do a little bit less damage if it's lightning. I guess we could try that. AI system, bombs going off. You got the FPS counter working? How'd you do that? Because you're in windowed mode, right? Yeah. So full screen, you can't have... Full screen mode does not allow the Steam FPS counter. Spread the lightning out? That's a suggestion as well. Well, the thing... No, but it doesn't... It wouldn't really matter if the lightning was spread out. The way the lightning works... Is it only... No, wait. Maybe it does do... That's a good question. Does lightning... Does a single lightning bolt actually affect multiple entities? I'm not sure. I don't know. Okay, here's the damage. Let's make this. Let's make this a variable before all this happens so we can affect it. So item equals this. Damage equals that. Now if we're using a lightning bomb, we can set the core damage to be less. Damage. So there, that's half the damage for lightning bombs only. And then that should not be a bug anymore. Make the lightning spread more? That's what Boogie was saying too. Yeah. Spread the damage. All right. It sounds like spreading the damage is it's a good thing to try. Let's, I'm gonna start with half the damage for the actual bomb itself first. And then I'll try spreading and also making sure that a single lightning bolt cannot damage more than one entity, or it spreads its damage over multiple entities like the sword does. The sword, when you swing the sword and you hit like three enemies at once, it does most of your damage to the first one, and then subsequent enemies get the other bits of damage. Still just worked them. But these are pretty weak enemies. I don't know. Let's see what happens if there's zero damage. That would show if it's zero damage, then all the damage is going to come just from the lightning effect. Yes, yeah, the fountain is a level. It's not a very good level yet. It's not done yet. It's gonna be a lot different than it currently is. Okay, so yeah, a little bit of damage coming from the bomb is okay. Forgot how much damage these things are meant to do. They're meant to do a lot of damage, the bombs. Because the thing is, a bomb, you're not guaranteed you're going to actually hit an enemy. That's why they're so... Maybe... You think lightning should hit multiple enemies. Yeah, well, it will. It's meant to hit multiple enemies. What I'm saying is it might spread its damage over those multiple enemies. So if it hits Like if a single lightning bolt hits three enemies at once, it would do most of its damage to the first enemy. It's a secret to everybody. Yeah, sorry, Scottish Pizza. That's already a bug, though. It's going to be fixed at some point where it will remember items. How come the poison bomb didn't just kill everybody on the screen then? Oh. Maybe the bomb itself. Yeah, the bomb itself is not applying. It's not spreading its damage. Hold on, when I was using the poison bomb, it didn't seem to kill everybody around. Make it rarer? Yeah, well, I kind of want them all to be somewhat balanced, because what I want the game to do is to randomize where the elements are in each world. So I could make lightning more rare than all other elements, but I'd rather not. I'd rather have them balanced so that you could encounter lightning at any point of any world, really. Yeah, you see that? It did not kill everybody around. Alright, if I take off poison entirely. I take off lightning entirely. Then both of these should be equal effects. What is future view hammering? I don't know. Yeah, it totally did, Azenris, right? It totally looked like it did completely zero damage. Which is very curious. I don't know why I would do that. Oh, I know why all of a sudden. I know why. It's the damage. It actually gets attenuated inside change HP. That's right. So elemental properties. Ice freezes, creates fire. Fire creates fire. Lightning, you know, shoots down a lightning bolt. Poison sets the damage to zero and then makes the damage happen over time. So that's true. It was setting completely zero damage. What this shouldn't be zero. This should be clamped minus something. So HP delta. HP, okay, so if you're getting poisoned, your HP delta should be, you should subtract at least, like, how much poison damage is done over time. Health system poison, I forget how much that does over time. I think it does, oh, okay, here's the damage count. It does 3 bits of damage, and I think it does, oh, yeah, a quarter tooth per time. So there's 3/4 of a tooth that you lose over time from the poison. And I could set that damage count higher, but that seemed to work pretty well. So this should be subtracted. You should subtract out. This is sine of HP delta. So this is HP delta equals oh man, this totally depends on if HP delta is less than zero. Actually, let's make poison only affect if HP delta is less than zero. That should be a safe assumption. You should never heal yourself and poison yourself at the same time. Or an enemy. They're party bombs! Yeah, if you use it on the ship, it should be rainbow colored. Yeah, sorry, Debian. No, there's nothing I can do about screen quality today. It's my internet speed is horrible. Hopefully by this Friday, Comcast will have come out and tried to fix the towers near me. Somehow, there's some problem in my area. They actually had to bring a technician out last week. And hopefully they have to come out this week again and fix the actual towers because they've already fixed the wires at my house. Everything's fine. My upload speed just was suddenly crap 4 weeks ago. And the stream has suffered the whole time. Yeah, and this is better quality than yesterday. Okay, so this is going to be clamp I HP delta plus CLF 0.75 times K life per container. The minimum is going to be whatever HPO delta is. The maximum is going to be zero. So there. This is going to make it so if you swing your sword and you hit someone with poison, it's only going to take away 3/4 of a heart. So if you do a bomb damage, it'll still carry over all that bomb damage. Yeah, until at least Comcast came out, right? Oh, I know. Oh, that sucks, right? I know, right? Seriously, come on, companies. Get your acts together. Admit that you have problems. We all have problems. Okay, so now the poison itself, when it launches a poison bomb, it should still do a lot of damage to these entities. It should kill these guys pretty fast. Alright, so these are pretty bad enemies to test this on because they're so weak. Let's go to a different area. But this is essentially what needs to happen for all these bombs. It needs to clamp itself by however much extra damage it's going to do. And in fact, I already know that lightning is going to probably do about half of a heart or so. So we'll clamp that there. All right, let's go to level 3. No, let's go to level like 6 or 7, where enemies are going to be stronger, maybe even 8. Let's find a big room full of enemies. Because they're totally not overpriced at all. Nice. Thank you for telling me to notice the kappa. It totally helps for me, because like, I don't know why, but I guess it's because I'm trying to code and talk and do all these other things at the same time. It's hard for me to notice little things like which emote is on my little tiny chat window over there. So it's very nice when you guys, if you are being sarcastic, say, like, notice the kappa. Alright, what we need here is a room full of lots of enemies. Like the switch room. This one will do. Let's call it. Let's do this one. Oh no, this has weak enemies. Yeah, I can't do this room. Cap alert! This is a horse. Right? Yeah, that's a good way to put it, Azarus. I should just realize that, huh? Wow. Where's the switch room in this level? This is the switchless level. It's a big level. Here we go. Plenty of enemies in here to get hit. Alright, so these guys, I'm not sure how much, how much health these guys have. Let's start putting some poison bombs out. Yeah, that's better. See, these guys are getting hit with damage over time. Kick my ass, though. Should I check this in more detail? Maybe I should check exactly how many hit points of damage this is doing, huh? Is there going to be any resurrect? Yeah, there'll be a resurrect type of health items, yeah. Yeah. Oh, this is a whole one, or no, negative one. Should be 0.25F times K life per container. So I guess lightning bolts do need to do more damage. Yeah, this is something that Hard-boiled Egg brought up anyways. Lightning swords are cool, they look sweet, but they really don't do that much extra damage. Especially when you compare it here to the poison. The poison does a whole 3/4 of a heart. Lightning only does 0.25. Let's make lightning be more effective. A whole 3/4 instant. Because what lightning does is it does random strikes too. So in essence, really, lightning should do maybe a whole one. Let's do lightning does a whole one. Because if it randomly strikes someone, and you have there's a random chance you might not even get hit by the lightning. Okay, let's see the lightning bomb now. What's up, Pedro? Is there any particular reason why you didn't choose Unity 3D as a dev tool? Yeah, there's a lot of reasons I did not choose Unity. But it's not really that I didn't choose Unity, it's that I chose Cocos 2DX. I chose Cocos 2DX because it's C++, first of all, and secondly, because it's cross-platform, and thirdly, because I'm extremely familiar with Cocos 2DX already. But fourth thing, and probably the biggest reason I use Cocos 2DX, is because it's a very DIY-style game engine. It's a do-it-yourself type thing. If something doesn't work, you can fix it. If it's, you know, if I want to go reprogram everything in Cocos 2DX and chop out sections of Cocos 2DX, I can. And also, it's very friendly for porting because it's C++. Wow, I got killed before I could even set a bomb down. Need more health. Set initial heal a little higher. Make it super OP. Oh, capo alert. Thank you. That's feeling pretty good. It probably needs to look a little better. Let's compare that to the regular bomb. If I set off three regular bombs in that room, how many enemies die? It should be comparable. Or maybe not. Maybe it shouldn't even be comparable. Maybe all the elemental bombs should just do more damage. Yeah, it looks like they killed about the same amount of foes. Okay, so, but maybe, yeah, maybe these bombs really should do more damage, the crafted ones. Maybe give it a random chance to do double damage. I like that. Critical hits. Can add a card for that. Cause that'll change everything. You know, I want to apply that to swords and everything, so that's a whole nother deal. So right now it's attenuating the HP delta. Based on elemental effects. I think if anything, it should do more damage. Yeah. So basically this just needs to be commented out. Lightning, poison. Fire, ice, all these. Wow. Nah, see the effects of. The effects of ice and fire can be so strong because ice freezes the enemy for so long. Fire creates all these fire entities, which also do a lot more damage. So I guess these should all have some kind of HP delta attenuation, but maybe just to varying degrees. So fire, for example, should knock off like probably a whole life container because these do like a whole half damage per time that you hit fire. Ice also I think does like half of one when it dies. Does Trello ever shrink during the stream? No. Trello never shrinks ever. Literally last week I had it down to 50 and now it's back up to 65. And some of these take an entire day. You know, it can be overwhelming to say the least to even look at it sometimes. But some of these things they are super quick. You know, I shouldn't be so negative. Like some of these I can knock off in less than 5 minutes. But you know, not all of them. Okay, this is good. There's a lot more balancing going on. Let's set off a firebomb in the middle of everything now. Right? I do some Tai Chi sometimes. Yeah, the card count, you have to turn it on. You have to start filtering. I'll show you how to turn it on if you want to see. See, the fire just killed everybody so fast. That one's overpowered. Yeah, so if you're on this, you just gotta go show menu and then click filter cards and then just press enter to filter nothing. And that shows you how many cards are in each one. I don't know why it doesn't add these until you filter, but yeah. And then if you turn off filtering, once your numbers go away, which is nice sometimes. Someday the Trello is gonna be empty. I'm gonna feel totally lost. Pizza, how did you lose your sword this time? Tell me exactly how you lost your sword. And you can get over 60? Right on. Yeah, clock. That's the idea, is to make it like that. Fire is not actually damage over time. Poison is the one that's damage over time, or acid. Fire, it creates an entity that actually damages other entities for a little while. So that fire is so powerful, it needs to be attenuated a lot. Either that or the actual fire entity itself. I got it totally wrong, no wonder. That's supposed to be zero. So all we gotta do is make sure that it does at least negative one damage. And also the fire entity, how much damage does that do? Because it should be pretty kick-ass. Like fire is such a great weapon, but It shouldn't be overpowered. Oh, here it is. 1, is that the damage? Come on. Yeah. Let's make that clear right now. Int damage equals, oh, this is the smallest amount of damage you can do. Well, well, well. Oh, we already had fire as a damage. Damage 1. Let's make sure that's the right number there. Yeah, damage flags. You finished level 2, teleported to the Songbringer. Wait, Pizza, did you teleport to the ship and go inside the... And did you teleport in and out from the Smith? I think I know what you're doing. Let me try this. Trello issue added. Lost and found in the game. What? What's that? I don't see any lost and found. Yeah, you can't warp from here. Did you try and craft your sword or something? What? How did you lose your sword? I don't understand. Where are you teleporting back from? Because I can't reproduce your bug. I don't even know how you got this shirt on. Yeah, I really need more information here. It's Pizza. I was just going to write something down or something, some note. I don't know. I'll work on this later. I can't focus on two things at once. Oh, it was a joke? All right. Yeah, but you shouldn't be able to teleport from the Smith. Oh, I just remember what I was going to write down. At least make it so the sword can be re-equipped if it isn't there. So that'll make it so if at least if I do that, you'll be able to go to your inventory and re-equip the sword if for some reason it's got unequipped. Okay, back to fire doing too much damage. You warp back from the center area? Okay. That's good to know. Why did Songbringer just get updated? It shouldn't have just gotten updated. It should have, it, unless you haven't played it. It should have, the last update I released was... Saturday. Okay, cool. Thanks. That'd be great. Yeah, to do a video of it, that'd be awesome. It updated? I mean, Steam could have done something in general to all their packages. I don't know. It is installing an update right there for me. And it did this to me yesterday when I was on Linux as well. This could have something to do with it. Will I still be accepting Trello issues after the beta? Of course. Yeah. The Trello will be live and in effect until the game is released. Actually, maybe even beyond the game's release. Maybe I'll keep it open after that. Because I would like to do enough updates that the game... See, yeah, it's updating. Why is it updating? I wish you could see what it updated, because I'm really curious. You know what? I can see what it would updated. It's diff-r, right? It's the recursive diff. Oh, it's lowercase r. Yeah, nothing changed. Absolutely nothing changed. This must have been something on Steam's end of things. So Steam must have released some kind of little... I don't know, minor update or something since... I have no idea. But the files are identical. Okay, so back to the bombs. There's a new file for you? What new file is there? The file's gone? What's up, Ethan? It was run as admin. Huh. That's weird. I don't know what it is. It's a Steam thing. Yeah, I don't know. I have no idea what that's all about. Okay, I think I made, what did I do here? To the fire? I just fixed the amount of damage it does. So, all right. Drop three bombs. Oh, see, that's a lot better. Yeah, okay, so that did fix it. So what the problem was is that it was doing way too much damage right here. It was doing full damage, so it really needs to take away a heart of damage from bombs before it does this, before it does the... Yeah, because basically what's going to happen is whenever a bomb goes off and enemies get hit, they instantly get turned on fire, which means a little fire entity gets created right there. And that little fire entity does a little bit of damage each time the enemy hits it, which it could do up to one, two, three. It could probably do up to two parts of damage, but one damage is probably a good number to put in here. So this fixed it. This made bombs less OP, fire bombs less OP. Let's test out the ice bomb now to make sure that thing is about the same strength as well. Huh, it just downloaded a 21 mega update? And what? It's doing. Like I said, it's completely the same game, at least for me, compared to what I uploaded and what it just downloaded and updated. It's exactly the same for me, but I am on Mac, well, it may have done something for Windows games. I have a feeling the ice bomb was weaker. That didn't feel like it was doing that much damage. It's probably because the enemy is frozen for so long, but I think it might be safe to go ahead and comment out the ice. Either that or to make the HP delta only change by a very small amount. Let's try it without first. Oh, it updated the redis files. I have a feeling that ice should do more damage once an enemy is unfrozen. So health system freeze. So when it unfreezes, it does a half heart of damage. That's a lot. Compared to poison, only does 3/4. So maybe it should do 3/4, actually. I don't know. It's just going to totally change the top hat, though. Taking the safe bet is to do that. Because it is a big advantage, the fact that the enemy is totally frozen for that long. Dude, 3 hours of sleep, that's it? Yeah, you talking about editing static variables? Please tell me, because there's a lot of game development left to do in this game. I'm thinking it should do more damage. It should be like 3/4 when it unfreezes. And only attenuating by a half. The alien font is used all over the place in the game for showing text in the alien language. Good enough for now. Let's go back to lightning bombs. Yeah, Scottish pizza. It's not just an empty ping file. It's the what you're probably seeing is a white background with some white text. About the same as the other ones. So and now lightning does a lot more damage too. So I hopefully that can. This one can be. This one can be archived. And I think this is good enough to check in at this point. Yeah, don't need to attenuate the damage of lightning bombs anymore from AI system. That's that was unnecessary. All right, I want to look over what you do is get a USB MIDI controller and then write some code that reads the values of those knobs on the controller and use those values to adjust a variable or constant you want to tweak. Interesting. The end effect is that you have knob sliders and they can be used to find the ideal values for damage movement. Yeah, I already have a MIDI controller that I could use for that. That's what I use to make my music, and that would be fine. It's got knobs and pressure-sensitive buttons. Pizza, the textures. Textures are in assets, textures. They're right there, man. They're right here with the alien font. It's called, they're called .pbr.ccz. All right, that was just setting the damage. Create fire. I modified a method of create fire to actually do damage or pass in damage. So I need to check all my instances of where I actually call it. Yeah, so that does one. That does zero. Okay, so that would have fixed lightning or light pillars. So okay, this is the main fix here is this is attenuating damage correctly for all the elements. HP deltas are clamped. Actually, all of these effects need to check if HP delta is less than zero. It should, like, if you're getting healed, it should never create a fire entity. It should never create lightning. Should never freeze. Yeah. Thanks, Saladonks. All right, Hardboiled. See you, man. Okay, so that's good. Oh. Oh, yeah, negative one is okay to clamp by. Okay, the next thing I want to make the lightning bomb look cool. So it needs to do... It needs to do smaller particles. The particles are a little bit too big right now. Just because they're super big. Scale. So yeah, pixel up ping. Let's see how that does. He doesn't deserve them. I noticed the kappa that time. Yay. That is kind of cool, but I think I'd like to see him fade really quickly. So that they could stay alive for a bit, but then they fade out quickly. Because they're meant to be like a sparkly, maybe even faster than that. Wait, height? Isn't little... Oh. Ground duration, fall duration, scale, fade duration, fall height... Jump height. Oh, fall height, jump height. Yeah, okay, this is the jump height right here. I can see them being up to a little bit bigger in their scale, too. Let's see how they look. I like it. Except that maybe not the scale. Let's so DRAND F 01. That was up to 0, 1, or 2. So let's do times 1.5 this time. Pema, you almost got 1,000 points too. 1,000 points, you can do a raffle. 25% chance to win a Steam key. Yeah, that's pretty good. I like how they fade out quickly too. Okay, great. Next up is the fear bomb. Let's make sure the fear bomb does some good amount of damage. And it needs to do the fear mechanic where it will scare enemies. Not bad. Oh, the Steam key, you go, I think it's, oh yeah, Steam key. Oh, thanks, Boogie. Oh, damn. Yeah, Solid Dunks, it's supposed to, but I'm going to work on that right now, so it doesn't yet. Scottish Pizza, if you want to give away, you can use give points. It's just throwing so much scale on there. So that, 0 point, wait, these are 1.0 plus DRNF01 times a half. Oh, Teak! Dang! Let me get you guys started off again here. Be a whole one, and then they need a special sound. Okay, but the next thing to do is to make fear actually do something to make the enemies run away for a minute. So this is a totally new mechanic. Back in health system, it does all these different effects like poison, lightning, fire, and all that. Let's start the fear effect. So fear causes panic. HP delta is less than 0, and the entity which is causing this hit point change, it has fear, and the entity that is being affected is not immune to fear, then it will do some kind of fear effect and possibly clamp the HP delta. Okay, so now it's just up to figuring out how to do a fear effect. Why does it keep indexing? Buffo! Oh, Salad Dongs, you won! Nice job, Salad Dongs. Salad Dongs won a Steam key today. So, Salad Dongs, all you gotta do is email me. I'll email you back a Steam key. You can do whatever you want with it. Play the game now. Give it to a friend. Sell it. Whatever. Just email me at nat@wizardfoo, and I will get you your Steam key. Nice way to win it. Oh, Zyger. I'm giving everybody points when they try because I'm just such a nice guy, aren't I? I'll get you started on your path back to trying again. Hopefully it doesn't sting as bad to lose so many points. Okay, so how to make a fear effect. Well, an AI could have a fear. But I really want it to affect not only the AI, but the player as well. But if it affects the player, how would it affect the player? I have this image of like of an of your keys not working the same for a while. So like if you're pressing up, it might randomly change to down or left or right or whatever. So in panic mode, maybe you're a little bit faster, like you run around faster and all your controls are messed up, but only a slightly bit faster. I think that'd be cool. Let's try that out. So I think what'll happen is you just need to do flags. There needs to be some flags for one of these entities, which either not an AI component, because I want it to be able to affect the player as well. So it has to be either the input component, the move component, or the collision component. Maybe the move component. Because that would, if it is going to be something that affects your, move already has flags. That would be great. Either way, moving would make sense to be put this flag in move, because if it's going to make enemies or the player or whatever run away, same thing. It would belong in move component. So let's make a flag. Okay, move. Pathfinding boundary, no auto stop. Let's add move panicked. Move panic! I've always wanted to type that. All right, there. Let's get that compiling. I already bought the game, so my plan is to sit on the key until the game is close to release and then give it to a really popular streamer I follow who would like to be. Oh, cool! Thanks, Saladongs. That's really awesome. Pema, Steam key negative. Trying to lower your chances. All right, pizza. See you, man. Yeah. Thanks, Saladongs. I really appreciate that. Seriously. This whole game would not be the same without you guys. All your constant support and encouraging energies and everything. I'm glad that, I'm glad that we've all found each other through this. Let me hook this word up so an entity could even start panicked. So K move panic. So I can fly you to the USA for a launch party? Don't fall for it, don't feed him. But he wants me to. All right, now it just needs to make it so if an entity is panicked, well, actually, let's make it so it's caused some panic. So we'll run some poison. How does poison work? It does schedule before tick over the damage interval. Unpoison. Oh, this is going to need a method like this. It needs a poison method. Health system is where it should be too. Okay, so we've got freeze, poison. It's called panic. We'll get that compiling. It'll be similar to this poison method. So if the entity doesn't have a move component, or they are already panicked, then this method's going to do nothing. I'll probably do some kind of trail as well, but let's try without a trail first. So it's adding the move flag, K move panic. Doesn't need to set a color on the entity, but maybe darkening the entity might be work. Your genius has been added to the list. So it's not going to do any damage yet. Here's where we unpanic. So duration is 3 seconds of panic. That could work at first. This is removing the panic flag, and this would restore whatever color they are. I guess flashing them at the end would be good, and actually restoring a color is fine to do. Okay, so this will make the entity get panicked. So collision fear. Health system panic. Okay, if I run it now, it shouldn't change anything. Everything should be exactly the same. But then we'll start applying panic effects. Because he likes you. Let's do this. So panic in the move system is going to just totally mess with an entity's movement. So here's where it applies a compass direction from an entity's. Okay, so if this move direction is not equal to k dir none, then make it random. So e.move.compassDir equals drand knum compassDirs. And then static cast that. Or, yeah, that's a quick way to do it. Static cast it. All right, this might really, really make things weird, though, because this is going to happen every single tick, which is 20 times a second. So 20 times a second, right? Or no, 30. Right now, it'll do 30 times a second. It'll change the compass direction. So entities are going to look really jittery. But let's see what happens. Swag points with a Z. Definitely got to spell swag. Whoa, look at this. It's just making everybody panicked all the time. Okay, so that's what they'll look like when they're panicked. It's so funny. Yeah, this is supposed to be if e.move.flags and k flag or k move panic. It's a dance party. Let's see what it looks like when the bomb actually goes off, though. Okay, yeah, we're back to regular movement. Let's set some bombs off. That kind of works. It's almost like they're... It's almost like they're stricken with fear, like they can't move for a minute. Huh. I kind of like it. Long stream! Health system panic. All right, don't flash an entity. If f dot health dot HP, it's already zero. No, if it has some hit points, that's only when you should flash. So don't flash a dead entity. Let's see what it looks like now. Well, no, that's going to be the same thing. I want to make it so it actually does a, sort of like a deterministic randomness. So, no, yeah, no, okay, I got it. It can add to this, instead of doing a totally random, let's try taking the compass direction and adding in the current tick and then shifting that down or dividing. Let's shift it down by 2. That would be divide by 4, which means that the 20, no, that's not enough. Needs to be like at least a half second, which would be shifted down 4. We need the milliseconds. It's kind of hard to tell what's going on now. Maybe that should be less. It worked. So what happens to me as a player if I get hit? I was holding left the whole time and it made me walk around in circles, which is not what we want. So right, the way this tick thing is working is it's not getting the right random. It's not random. It's actually making all entities go in perfect circles. But it's the right concept. It just needs the right. It needs the, like a DRAND index or something. I think kit.h. All right, I got an idea. I want to do DRAND. Int DRAND at. And this is going to be int index. So that will give me the random number at the exact index. So that can give me, I can always give me a random number, but it can make it deterministic depending on the tick. It will have a certain randomness. So this function is going to be called DRAND at, give it an index. It gives you exactly that number at that index. So this is going to become compass direction. E, I moved a compass there. Plus D ran at tick, get tick, shifted down a bit. Okay, so this should make it so if I get hit by the fear bomb, I shouldn't run around in a circle. That didn't even work. Did I get hit? Oh yeah, it still made me run in a circle though. What? Wait, did it even compile this? Xcode's been crazy lately. It just won't even compile certain files sometimes. Oh, there we go. Yeah, he's all random now. Cool. That was pretty good. Let's see if it's fast enough. Okay, I didn't get hit that time. Liking this. Okay, let's make it clearer when an entity is being affected by this. So health system panic. Let's actually make them dark. So they'll set, apply the tone. Three B white. So make them half of their original tone. Let's see this back at level 2. This is kind of confusing seeing so many entities like that. Oh, wait, let's keep that position though. Hey, you guys, I already have a VPS. If anybody wants to, if you guys really want to, I can put Bafu on the server. But it wouldn't be, like, easy to change him, though. That's the problem. You'd have to have me, like, log in and change the code for Bafu all the time. Sweet, this is funny. Totally, $5 a month, yeah. Where do you get a VPS for $5 a month? What's up, J2? It's going great, man. Yeah, I've been here almost every day. I'm in here. All right, cool. But yeah, it's VPSs are pretty cheap these days. The one I have is $20 a month, and it's great. And that's I run my whole website Wizard Foo off of that. I'm thinking of making this a little bit more jittery. Uber space. Wow. DigitalOcean is $5. It's awesome. Yeah. Yeah. So it's kind of like I have Linode and it's also full access. It's like the only limitation is that it's shared. So but all you're sharing is a CPU. I think. You get your own RAM, if I understand correctly. So, but I've never ever had any problems with Linode. I've been on DreamHost before, and DreamHost was crap. So many problems with their VPS. But I've never tried DigitalOcean. See, that's too jittery. I like this effect. This is so funny. This should be a floating point number calculation here. So this should be float ticket tick. Oh, actually, this can be computed before. Int panic offset equals float tick get tick times whatever the panic effect is. I had it at shifted down 2, which is a quarter, and that felt pretty good. But maybe a little. No, I need to make that actually an integer based on k ticks per second. Let's do drand at panic offset. Oh, and this is never going to change either, so that should just be, whatever. Okay, so, oh, I could even increase the panic offset by 1 every time. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, sorry, the video's blurry. Oh, I forgot all about Bafu being C sharp. Oh. Yeah, my VPS is out then. Unless there's some cross-platform way you can run C sharp. You're not even mad. So if I want the tick to be times a quarter, that's k seconds per tick. K seconds per tick is 1 over that. If I want that to be times, it's going to be 0.25 divided by 30. So 0.800. Well, let's just do times 0.25 over k ticks per second. Yeah, and then every time this is actually used, I can increase the panic offset so that it will be different for every entity that calls it. All right, let's see that now. No, don't need to rewrite it. You can say, so you can run mono. I wonder if it works in mono. That didn't work. I also messed up on this math. Oh yeah, this is supposed to be to quarter. Oh, times delta times a quarter over k ticks per second. Or maybe times k ticks per second. Or delta times k ticks per second. Oh, yeah, yeah. I think it's supposed to be a quarter times delta times k ticks per second. So if I later go and change k ticks per second, the panic will still run exactly the same. Oh, there we go. It's back to panicked. Panic's funny. All right, let's see that. It's probably gonna kill all these blobs in this room, but let's see what happens in there. Yeah, lightweight distro. Lubuntu? Is that super lightweight? How lightweight is Lubuntu? Yeah, I'm assuming it's Ubuntu with like just lighter. How big is a Lubuntu install? Oh, it's medium way, huh? There's no video all of a sudden? Well, I mean, the stream's almost over anyways. Man, it sucks that the two lane heads are horrible, right? Well, I know you guys can't really see what's going on, but all I'm doing is testing out this fear bomb a little bit before I shut the stream down. So really, almost done. So I want to see these enemies run around more. Yeah, okay, they're jittering a little bit. Okay, fear is working pretty good. Basically what fear does is it makes an enemy run around in random directions. Or you, if you get affected by fear, your controls are all wonky for a good 3 seconds. Yeah, so see you guys later. See you later, Zynger. Bye, everybody. Have a good night. I'm about to check this code in and get some dinner. So that's it for day 310, Mike and Songbringer. I'll be back later on. Same wizard time. So cheers, everybody. Have a good night. Thank you for being awesome.